Hey everybody, so I'm here with Miss Sharon Stone. You've been a muse for me for so many, my whole life.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Sharon Stone.
I'm really proud of you. You are a Renaissance woman. You are an inspiration. You really are. I'm obsessed with casino. The gold dress was honestly...
That dress weighed about 1,000,000 pounds.
I heard you gave it away to a friend.
And those sequins, no. It was from a costume rental house.
Really?
And it had to go back because it was a vintage dress. But every sequin was cutting my neck.
Wow.
And cutting my armpits. Because they're really made of metal from the 60s.
Yeah.
And it was a vintage dress.
Was it?
It was so heavy, but I was like, I'll be wearing it, holding my neck up.
It was literally iconic, and I grew up as a fashion designer. You literally are and were a muse to me growing up. You're a blonde bombshell. One more question regarding the fashion. What do I have to ask you? You're right in front of me. I'm never going to have this opportunity again.
You're going to ask me why and how I always had so many amazing fashion moments.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sharon Stone.
Come on.
Thank you. Very nice.
I told you I was hot today.
Amazing stylist.
This is Paris LeVay.
Yes.
Paris LeVay has been my stylist,
Hi, Paris.
My creative director, really, let's just be honest. When Paris is not around, I'm in my pajamas.
So you trust your stylist.
And when he came over tonight, I had something else out, and he said, you're not wearing that, you're an artist, you're wearing this.
Yeah, it's admirable that you actually take your stylist seriously.
Are you kidding? This man runs the second largest publishing house in the world.
I fell in love right there.
Yes, this is what it takes just for one girl to go up the stairs on the red carpet.
It's such an honor being here at your amazing show. The Kairos painting is absolutely insane. Because I know what you mean by it, what he resembles in mythology about, you know, fate. Just kismet? Is that the word? But you know, what's meant to be is meant to be, and you have to go out and make your dreams happen.
He was one of two gods, but he was a demigod who could go between heaven and hell. And I just think that we're all sort of doing that now. He was the god of good fortune. And I think that we have to believe in ourselves and our good fortune. I don't know, after my brother died.
My condolences
thank
to you,
you
and your family.
That's what happened, I painted that.
It's my favorite painting of the entire exhibit.
Thank you.
While it's flooding down in Texas, all of the telephone lines are down.
When I first first came here, you know, and I was a painter and a writer and a poet, and I used to go read poetry.
How do you do it all, and who believed in you to give you the confidence to do
that? And I
try to prove everyone wrong.
Right.
How did you make it happen? Who was the person that gave you the start?
My dad would just say to me, no one's going to give you respect.
No.
You have to demand respect.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
And then...
Because you have to go out, but you go what you want.
I got in trouble in school because I was ahead, and I was doing things ahead and showing people in my class in elementary school how to do ahead things.
Yeah.
And they called my parents in and said, your daughter is doing things and she's doing this and she's teaching other people that. And my dad said, is that true?
And I'm sure you said, yeah.
I said, yes.
Yeah.
And he said, come over here. And I'm scared. And I came over.
Really?
Yeah.
You seem like you would be confident.
Not of my dad.
No.
And so I walked over there and I said, yes, sir. And he said, I'm goddamn proud of you. And he turned to the principal and said, she's going to keep on doing it. Let's go. You know, when I first came here, everybody said to me, stay in your lane.
Yeah, well, that's Hollywood.
And then I did Basic Instinct after I did the comedy, Irreconcilable Differences, which I was very successful as a comedian. I did Basic Instinct and then everybody said, stay in your lane.
It was like
comedy was my lane a minute ago. I'm finished my painting. I'm so psyched. It actually looks like something, which I find completely remarkable. You can do something you didn't know you could do. I made a painting. That was my small step at learning something.
You are a Renaissance woman. You're an inspiration. You really are. Thank you. I'm really proud of you.
No, go get them.
Yeah.